Now, one of the most underrated smartphones of 2020 is undoubtedly the iQOO 3. Now, not only is this the most affordable smartphone that you can buy, which comes with the Snapdragon 865 processor, but it also makes a very strong case for being the best, if not one of the best phones for gaming. So, I thought that in this video, I'd compare it to the recently launched OnePlus 8 to see which of these two phones offers you better performance for your buck. Oh, and stay tuned to the end of this video because we will be giving away one unit of the iQOO 3 and one unit of the OnePlus 8 as well. So, let's go. So, now first thing we're going to do is we're going to run AnTuTu benchmark on both the smartphones, and we will be running two instances of the benchmark to see if there is any performance throttling with either of the two handsets. So, without any further ado, let's run the benchmark. Now, before I start, I just want to show you that there is nothing else running in the background, and same goes for the OnePlus phone too. There is nothing else running in the background now. So let's just start these two benchmarks. Great. Okay guys, so this was the first run of AnTuTu benchmark on both the smartphones. As you can see, the iQOO 3 scored over 13,000 points higher than the OnePlus 8 did. So now what we are going to do is we are going to quickly run the benchmark again to see if there is any throttling on either of the two phones. Okay guys, so this is the second run of AnTuTu benchmark, and wow, the OnePlus 8 has drastically dropped its score. So it scored 570,000 some points in the first run, and it has dropped over 70,000 points in the second run. And as you can see, the iQOO 3 score is extremely consistent. So without any further ado, what I will do now is run Geekbench on these two phones, and again we'll run two instances of Geekbench on both the smartphones. But I'm very surprised with the OnePlus 8's performance right here. Now we will run Geekbench 5 on both the smartphones. So here we go. Okay guys, so the first run of Geekbench 5 has completed. So as you can see, the iQOO 3 had higher single core as well as multi-core score as compared to the OnePlus 8. But what we'll do is we are going to run these scores again. Alright, so the second run of Geekbench 5 is on its way now. Let's see if there is any performance throttling in this benchmark on either of the two handsets. Okay guys, so the second run of Geekbench 5 is also completed. Again, extremely consistent scores from the iQOO 3, 924 single core score, which is the same as we saw in the last run, and the multi-core score is the same as well. But when you look at the OnePlus 8, the score is actually plummeting by quite a margin. So that's it for the benchmarks guys. What we will now do is play PUBG for 30 minutes on both the smartphones, and then we'll talk about the final verdict. Okay guys, so now we will be doing a quick PUBG gameplay on both the smartphones, on the iQOO 3 as well as the OnePlus 8. So right now in my hand, as you can see, I have the iQOO 3. And the reason why there is a USB cable connected to the phone, that's because I'm actually capturing the game data in real time to my PC, which is running Geekbench right now, which is why I have connected the USB cable to this phone so that it can capture all the data in real time, and then I can show you in the end a very nice, neat graph as to which smartphone performed the best. So two things that I instantly want to tell you about the iQOO 3's design, even before we start with the gameplay. One is that, which obviously make it a slightly better option for gaming. Number one, it's that it comes with these two pressure keys on top, capacitive keys on top, which essentially can, you know, you can map your trigger buttons to these, which gives you more screen real estate, more room on the screen to actually see what's going on. Now, for the purpose of this test, I'm not actually enabling that feature because I want to keep the testing as consistent as possible across both the smartphones, which is why I'll only be using touch-based controls for both. But yeah, if you're serious about gaming, then do check out these pressure-sensitive capacitive keys on the iQOO 3. Now, the second thing that I want to talk about is that it comes with a headphone jack, which means that while my phone is connected to my PC, or say if you are charging your phone, you can still actually connect a pair of headphones to the smartphone, which is obviously going to give you a much better experience when gaming as compared to the OnePlus 8. So for that purpose, I have my one more quad drivers right here with me, and I will be plugging those in to play this game right now. Right, so as you can see, I've plugged in my earphones now. They're much better. All right, so okay guys, so here's how we will be testing this game on the iQOO 3 and the OnePlus 8. So I will straight away jump into a classic match, Erangel, and I will game for 30 minutes on both the smartphones, on both the iQOO 3 as well as the OnePlus 8. So without any further ado, let's do that. But just a second, I just want to show you that this phone can actually play this game on HDR and extreme graphics. The colorful mode is enabled, anti-aliasing and shadows both are enabled. So pretty much the max possible settings that you can play PUBG in India right now, the iQOO 3 can do that. So with that out of the way, now we can just start with our gameplay. Okay guys, so now that we have jumped into a game, let's go. I have started the game benchmark as well. So yeah, you can see that it's recording now. So I haven't played this game in a while, I'll be honest with you guys, but that's primarily been because I couldn't really use the headphone jack, my earphones, and it's pointless to play PUBG without earphones, so. See, this is where having earphones comes in clutch. I heard the player before I saw the player. So if you're playing this game, please play it with a pair of earphones. That's going to give you the best possible experience. I did not even know that there was a player there. I did not see him first, I just heard him instantly. Also, you can see that there are literally no frame drops. The game is running absolutely fine. There are no lags, no stutters, nothing. It's rendering everything beautifully. That's what I like to see. Okay guys, so 15 minutes in, I just wanted to give you a quick update. So the temperatures are fine on the iQOO 3. It's getting slightly warm on the camera module, but I think that's to be expected. But outside of that, no lags, no stutters, nothing. Also, the metal trim is also getting slightly warm. But again, that is to be expected when you're playing PUBG, a game like PUBG, which is very graphically intensive. But yeah, on the whole, very, I don't really see any problems with the phone so far. So, yeah. Okay guys, so we have been playing for 21 minutes, 9 more minutes of this, and then we are going to end the game. Okay guys, 30 more seconds and then I'm going to have to quit the game. At least I'll stop the testing. I won't quit the game, I'll finish the game and then I'll... Yeah. Okay guys, so 30 minutes have elapsed. I'm going to pause the game, stop the testing now. So yeah. That is great. Let me just finish this game now. So I've stopped the testing on GameBench. So the metrics that the program will show are only going to be for 30 minutes and not a second beyond that. But just for the fun of it, I want to finish this game now. Oh shit. All right. So, great game on the IQ 3. Now we are going to test the same on the OnePlus 8. So, give me a second and I will just switch the phones now. Okay guys, so now we will be playing PUBG Classic Wrangle Match on the OnePlus 8. So, before I start the game, let me just show you that I am in fact running it on the max possible settings. HDR Extreme, Colorful, Anti-Aliasing is enabled and Shadows have been enabled as well. Now, like I mentioned when I was playing with the playing PUBG on the IQ 3, this phone does not come with a headphone jack, which means that I'll basically have to rely on the phone's speaker setup. So I'm going to just turn the volume all the way up to the max. And yeah, let's start. So the recording has also started. Alright, great. So it is recording now. Capturing all the data in real time. Let's see how far we can go in this one, right? So, in the last game with the IQ 3, I finished third. And I was very happy with that result because I haven't actually played in a very long time. So I hope we can achieve a similar result. If not, then again, like I mentioned previously, I'll just quit the game and then I'll hop back into the match. So I want to play it safe so that I can actually play for 30 minutes without having to exit the game again. But again, like last match, I had about 7-8 kills, so I'm not going to play it too safe also, but relatively safe. Okay, so let's go to Gutka only. I think that's what my gut is telling me, to go to Gutka. Alright, let's go guys. Come on. What? There are people here? Oh, there it is. See, that's the issue with not playing with headphones. I couldn't make out if there were people here or not. Also guys, just one quick thing that I would like to point out. This phone is already getting really warm. So this phone is already about as warm as the, what do you call it? As the IQ 3 was after 30 minutes of gaming. So I definitely feel it. This phone is getting way too warm to the touch, guys. Like, we have played this game for 10 minutes exactly, and yeah, it's very warm now. This is not the kind of temperatures you would want to game on. Guys, by the way, we have been playing for 26 minutes, 3 more alive, 3 minutes to go. So there's definitely one guy there. There is one guy definitely in this house. So guys, 30 more seconds and then I'll stop the test, but I will finish the game. And alright guys, 30 minutes are up, so I'm gonna stop the test now. And the test has been stopped, but let's just continue with the game for a bit more and see exactly what position we can take. Hey, chicken dinner. Hey, nice. Great game. Had a lot of fun. Got a chicken dinner. Okay guys, so what we are going to do now is, now we are going to talk about the verdict, is what we are going to do.
Okay, so before I get on with the verdict, let me quickly explain the giveaway rules. So if you want to win an IQ 3, then all you have to do is subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on all our social media handles, the links for which will be in the description box below. Also make sure to comment which of these two phones would you rather have. Would you rather have the OnePlus 8 or the IQ 3? Now, If you want to win the OnePlus 8, then all you have to do is go on over to our Instagram handle, the Mr. Phone, and we are hosting a separate contest for this phone there as well. So now that we have that out of the way, let's talk about the verdict. Okay, so the iQOO 3 starts at ₹34,990, which makes it a considerably more affordable phone when compared to the OnePlus 8, which starts at ₹42,000. Now, both the smartphones perform really well, but I have to hand it to iQOO as the iQOO 3 is just a better phone for spec heads like me. Firstly, let's talk about the benchmarks, where not only did the iQOO 3 get much higher scores in both Antutu and Geekbench compared to the OnePlus 8 in the first run, but in the second run, the smartphone didn't deviate from its original scores all that much. The OnePlus 8, on the other hand, clearly showed signs of struggles whilst operating under a constant workload, and the phone's Antutu score dipped by almost 70,000 points, which is just baffling. Now, in terms of gaming, both the smartphones offered the same median FPS and FPS stability. However, the OnePlus 8 got quite warm after playing PUBG on it for half an hour. Now, the iQOO 3, on the other hand, offered much better thermals, and it also shipped with a headphone jack as well as a capacitive trigger buttons, which I'm sure will only add to a player's gaming experience. Now, on top of all of that, the iQOO 3 comes with 55-watt fast-wire charging, which means that the smartphone will refuel faster as compared to the OnePlus 8 after a gaming session too. Now, I will admit that the OnePlus 8's display is, the 90Hz display is actually really good for gaming, but if I'm being honest with you, then most Android games don't even surpass the 60fps mark, so gaming on the iQOO 3's display is also not going to be a deal-breaker for you. Everything considered though, the iQOO 3 is an excellent smartphone for gaming, and I cannot wait to see what the company comes up with next. Now, that wraps up this video from my end, but do let me know in the comments below as to which smartphone would you rather have for gaming. Would you rather have the OnePlus 8 or the iQOO 3? And do like and share this video if you enjoyed it. Until next time, this is Prateek from Mr. Phone signing off.